Touchstone Exploration has released an operational update, and I'm delighted to be joined by the President and the Chief Executive, Paul Baay. So, Paul, an operational update. Can you talk me through the highlights, first of all?
Yeah, I think really three parts to this release. One is the update on our Coho project, when it's coming on stream. Second part is sort of an update on the Cascadura project. And then the third part is the sort of drilling program that's going to kick into place here as soon as we get some of this new production on stream. But, you know, and I think in fairness, there's obviously some disappointment and frustration on the length of time it's taking to get Coho on. All I can really say is we just, you know, continue to push forward as hard as we can, you know, subject to all sorts of things that are happening. But we can talk about that a little bit more. But I think, you know, we're trying to give the good news and the bad news, and this is really just to keep everybody up to date on where we are on the journey.
All right, then. So you mentioned Coho. Why has first gas from Coho been delayed, and when can we expect the well to come online?
Yeah, I think that's probably the biggest question. I mean, there's been a number of reasons why it's been delayed, and you know, some of those have been weather delays, but we, you know, we're not going to blame the project on the weather. We should be able to work that into our schedule. But the biggest challenge here is we've got three different parties working on this project. We've got us, we've got the National Gas Company of Trinidad, and then we've got Shell that we're ultimately tying into. And every time a change is made or a new design element comes up by any of those parties, it has to circle around and go through all the approvals of all three parties. And probably the biggest change in the last month is there's been some design changes at where we tie into Shell. So that's been refabricating things, redesigning, redoing everything. And basically it's pushed the project out another month. But, you know, there's nothing we can really do about that. That's up to Shell and to the design that works for them. Plus, you know, NGC is ultimately going to be the owner of this project. And so it has to meet their design specs. So frustrating, yes, but, you know, we are making progress forward. And that's really all I can continue to do with the team.
Okay, so in terms of progress, you are expecting the environmental impact assessment approval by the end of this month. So what are the next steps for Cascadura once it has been received?
Yeah, and that's really the button for Cascadura is when can we get started with that environmental impact assessment? You know, just to kind of show the level of engagement, you know, the government's working on this on Saturday. We were back and forth with them on Saturday on some additional questions that they have in there, but they, you know, they reiterated on Saturday that they're working to that June 30th date, which is this week, to try to get something back to us. So, you know, everybody's working again on that. It's a very large project. I mean, we have to keep that in mind. It's once we get the EIA, we then go in and do the surface work. All of the equipment's pretty much been ordered. All the design's been done. We've got a few final contracts to issue, but you know, we can hit the ground running once we get the EIA. So that's obviously the focus, and we'll let everybody know as soon as we get that.
Okay, so how significant is first gas from Cascadura to Touchstone? And do you anticipate any delays to the original timeframe?
So sort of two parts to that question. And, you know, like if you look at Coho, it'll double production from where we are today when it comes on. And then Cascadura, you know, it takes us up about another 9,200, 9,500 BOEs a day. So, you know, we kind of go from 1,500 where we are today, 1,500 where we are today, to something that's north of 12,000 by the end of the year. So you can kind of see the step change that we're managing. It's the first time new gas will come on in Trinidad in 20 years. So I think that sort of is also compounding to the issues. It's, you know, something that hasn't happened onshore in a very long time in Trinidad. So, so that's where we're at with that project, and the significance of it, I mean, is obviously huge to us and to the shareholders.
So what does it mean for the country? Because you've just said that it's going to be the first onshore natural gas project to come on stream in 20 years. So I can imagine incredibly important.
Yeah, it really is. And, you know, that's probably part of the frustration, too. I think a lot of the shareholders are feeling is you've got this shortage of gas on the island. You've got this opportunity to bring on this big volume of gas. And it just seems that we're getting really dragged out on this. But I think everyone has to remember that, you know, there is a process that needs to go through. This is a big project that's being done. So we need to make sure that we've got all the right environmental impacts, the right consultation done, the right design done. high pressure gas. So there's, you know, a bunch of safety issues on it. So, you know, it's a very large project, and that doesn't mean that I'm apologizing. I think it just the complexity of this is maybe, you know, we haven't maybe explained that well enough as we've gone through here. But, you know, it's a very large project, and it's making good headway at this point.
Okay, a very large project, but is the company fully funded to bring Cascadeira online?
Yeah, I think that's the other part that's maybe, you know, shareholders are finding a little frustrating, is we're not kicking off the drilling program because we want to make sure that the funds that we have get us through to first production, both at Coho and Cascadeira. And, you know, we've been very clear on that for the last year, that we want to make sure that we know exactly when these projects are coming on so that we've got lots of cash to finish them. So the short answer to that is yes. And the long answer to it is we're just cash managing through these projects because we just don't want to raise any equity.
Okay, so you're sounding a little bit downbeat today, Paul, but what can we look forward to?
Well, I think, you know, I am a little downbeat. It's anytime you got to, you know, keep reiterating there's delays. I think, you know, it's frustrating for us. It's frustrating for shareholders. But, you know, you really got to look and keep our eye on the long game here. We have this huge reserve base that we found. And now we just got to get it on stream. We've got a market for it. You know, we go from, you know, 1500 BOEs or barrels a day to something that's going to be, you know, I think you can see visibility through to 20,000 BOEs a day during 2023. Like, you know, that's as upbeat as I've, you know, the opportunity I've gotten. That's assuming not drilling any more wells. So nothing else in the program. So, you know, I think that's the real opportunity. I share everybody's frustration on the time delays, but it's just the reality of where we're working, the environment we're working in, the time that we're working in, and, we're just going to keep pushing and we'll keep everybody up to speed as best as we can, good or bad.
Many thanks. Paul Baay, President and Chief Executive of Touchstone Exploration. Thank you very much indeed.
Thanks, Sarah. Appreciate it.